Hello there, this is Lynn Allen. Welcome to another AutoCAD tip courtesy of Cadalyst Magazine, and Happy New Year. Thank you so much for joining me. Today I'm going to share with you a tip that has to do with layers. Okay, so now the layer command is the third most frequently used command in AutoCAD. So any tips that have to do with layers should technically save you a lot of time, right? That's what I'm hoping for. So I'm going to go into the layer dialog box, and we're going to talk about some things that seem pretty darn basic, but they're going to really come in handy. So let's say I want to make new layers. So I'm sure by now, hopefully you've learned that whatever layer you have highlighted, for example, if I have the plant shrubs layer highlighted, and I select new to create new layers, which you can of course also do with an Alt N for those of you who like to type. When I click on that new layer dialog box, it's going to make a duplicate of that layer with a different name, right? So it's kind of important to make sure as you create new layers that you have a layer highlighted that is the closest to the new layers as you could possibly get. All right, so that's one way to create new layers. We also saw you can do Alt N. But then I have to go back and I have to change the name of the layers to be what I want them to be. And I'm very lazy. So I'm gonna share with you a tip that I think you're gonna really find comes in handy. You can actually just type in layer names separated by commas. For example, I can type in a 1 and a comma and a 2 and a comma and a 3 and a comma. Can you see that it's creating layers one by one there with the name that I chose? And the only thing I had to do was to delineate them, separate those with commas. That's faster. That's going to save you some time. And I thought I'd also share with you, this is kind of random, but did you know that you can do crossing windows inside of the layer dialog box? Just select a variety of layers. And we're all great at crossing windows, right? We're professionals at that. So I thought I'd just share that little tidbit with you. Now I'm going to go out of the layer dialog box and I'm going to do an undo. And you will see that every single thing that I just did in the layer dialog box has been undone. Okay, that's because of a setting in the undo command. I just want to make sure that you know about that because maybe that's not the way you want to roll. When I go into the undo command, you'll see that there's an option on there that says layer equals yes. That means when you do an undo, it undoes everything that you did in the last time that you were in the layer dialog box. All right, so let's go to C for control. And let's go to L for layer, and I'm going to say no. All right, let's go back in the layer dialog box, and let's make a couple new layers, all right? I'm gonna make a layer maybe 4 and 5 and 6. Now I'm gonna leave this dialog box. I'm gonna go out of there. And now if I do an undo, it's only going to undo the last thing that I did in the layer dialog box. If I come back into the layer dialog box, you can see that I still have layer 4 and 5, but I do not have layer 6. Interesting, huh? So decide how you want the undo command to work. That's totally up to you. I know some people who don't like it to undo everything that they just did in the layer dialog box. They just want it to undo the last thing that they did while they were in the layer dialog box. So that's up to you. So there are some tips for you that have to do with layers. I hope that you enjoyed them, and I'll see you back here in 2 more weeks. Have a great 2015.